7 ways the Earth changes in the blink of an eye.
From islands popping out of the ocean during earthquakes to glaciers calving icebergs every hour, the Earth can undergo dramatic changes right before your eyes. These 7 rapid geological transformations have fascinated scientists and struck fear in the hearts of everyone else for ages. Most geologists believe that the key differentiation process in the Earth was melting of much of the inner rock material after the Earth formed. The source of the heat was radioactive minerals trapped in the Earth as it formed. Gradually, those minerals released heat as radioactive atoms decayed. Natural disasters are extreme, sudden events caused by environmental factors that injure people and damage property. Earthquakes, windstorms, floods, and disease all strike anywhere on Earth, often without warning. Disasters occurred around the world throughout history, and we don't know the right time of when it will happen. We begin at number 7. A new coast. Earthquakes not only rattle the Earth, but they radically change the landscape. The Chilean earthquake that struck on February 27 changed the country's landscape by raising the ground by more than 8 feet, 2.5 meters, near the coast and sinking land farther inward, a recent study found. The massive quake caused marine platforms to rise out of the ocean, thereby shifting the coastline in some places 1,640 feet, 500 meters, closer to the ocean. Next is the White Fringe. This is the uplifted marine platform in Calatayani, was covered in dead white algae after the earthquake. Here, uplift was about 51 inches, 130 centimeters, and killed almost all the mollusks and algae that live in the waters near the shore. And last is Dichato, Chile. Studying how the earthquake moved the land is more than an academic curiosity. Chile is situated atop a hotspot for earthquake activity. Learning how this magnitude 8.8 quake moved the land will tell scientists more about what causes large earthquakes. In this image, uplift is seen in the south part of the city of Dichato, home to 3,000 people. The city of Dichato was one of the hardest hit by a tsunami that reached 33 feet, 10 meters, high, and washed more than 0.6 miles, 1 kilometer, landward. An estimated 90% of the town was destroyed. The new study that measured the land changes in this area is just one of many studies currently investigating the Chilean earthquake, which geophysicist Michael Bevis of Ohio State University said will probably turn out to be one of the most important earthquakes ever in terms of scientific impact. At number 6. The Ice Conveyor Belt. Glaciers, huge rivers of ice formed when snow and ice accumulate over hundreds and thousands of years, act like a big conveyor belt that pushes ice into the sea. These icy rivers move slowly over time, some eventually dumping ice chunks into the sea, a process known as calving, a leading source of additional water for the world's oceans. Some kinds of glaciers, however, calve as often as once an hour. These kinds of glaciers are called grounded, meaning they rest on the ocean floor. Others float on top of the ocean waters as they run into the sea. Scientists recently observed Alaska's Columbia Glacier undergoing a transition from grounded to floating, which dramatically slowed its calving. Scientists set up camp where the Columbia Glacier meets the ocean in this photo from August 2009. The scientists' orange tents are seen on the cliff in the lower left-hand corner of the image. Only accessible by helicopter, 3 to 5 scientists will spend up to a month camped out on the wet terrain surrounding the glacier. They deploy instruments to measure the glaciers, take photographs, and make observations in the field. The instruments do not transmit their data back to the lab, so twice a year scientists trek to Columbia to retrieve it. Scientists captured a dramatic submarine iceberg calving at the grounded end of the Columbia Glacier on June 17, 2005. The height of the ice cliff is roughly 230 feet. Glaciologist O'Neill of the USGS is pictured here checking up on the seismometer that measured the activity of the Columbia Glacier in May 2009. Think of a calving event kind of like a little earthquake, O'Neill told your Amazing Planet. Seismometers tell us when and how long it took to break off, and also gives us ideas about how it was created. Tad Pfeffer is seen photographing the Columbia Glacier from the western boundary in June 2005. The scientists do more than just take pretty pictures. Try also make quantitative measurements with their images. Pictures taken with this camera help scientists calculate how fast the ice is flowing and also measure the glacier's geometry. Adam Lewinter is servicing one of the time-lapse cameras at Columbia Glacier. Time-lapse images provide one of the primary sources of data used in this study. We use them to identify times when large calving events occur and then look at the seismic data during those periods to study the fracture process, O'Neill said. In 2004, the time-lapse cameras took 4 to 6 pictures per day. At number 5. Volcano collapse. Massive volcanic eruptions creates ashes and pumice into the sky and can be heard thousands of miles away and even seen from space. But volcanoes can change the landscape in the blink of an eye in a way other than blowing off their tops by triggering huge landslides. Thousands of years ago, a large collapse of the edifice of the Soufriere Hills volcano on the island of Montserrat in the Lesser Antilles sent landslides into the ocean. Some of these landslides involved nearly 1.2 cubic miles of material that traveled underwater for miles. Volcanic dome collapses occur when dome-shaped lava mounds on top of a volcano break apart due to a gas pressure buildup. Soufriere Hills eruptions have produced some of the largest volcanic dome collapses ever recorded. At number 4. Massive landslides. Landslides can wipe away villages in a second, even when volcanoes aren't involved. Heavy rains triggered landslides on the slopes of Mount Elgon in Uganda on March 1, 2010. Landslides are common in the region, but these recent landslides are much larger than previous ones. These buried 3 villages, leaving 83 dead and more than 300 missing, as of March 8, reported the United Nations Office for the Coordination of Humanitarian Affairs. The Ugandan government has also stated that deforestation may have played a role in the landslides. At number 3. Avalanche. When mountaintop glaciers collapse, they can trigger an avalanche of ice and debris down the mountain. Such was the case for Mount Kazbek in southern Russia when the Kolka glacier collapsed on September 20, 2002. In the above image, the dark gray streak shows the gorge that was overrun by ice, rock, water and other debris from the avalanche. The avalanche plowed down the Janaldan River Valley at speeds up to 112 miles per hour and buried parts of a village with a layer of ice and rock 427 feet thick. Avalanches, along with other deadly natural disasters such as heat waves and floods, could become more common in mountainous regions thanks to climate change, according to a recent study. In the Alps, where temperatures have increased twice as much as the global average temperature since the late 19th century, and are predicted to rise by an average of 0.54 to 0.9 degrees per decade in the next century, these threats are a real concern. At number 2. Rapid megaflood. Some of the most spectacular canyons on Earth were probably formed in the geologic blink of an eye, suggests a recent study that found clues to their formation deep in the heart of Texas. As anyone living in Comal County, Texas can attest, they can form even faster. Lake Canyon Gorge, a 23 feet deep canyon, was carved in just 3 days by a flood in 2002. The flood scoured a swath of greenery in this Texas town, leaving sand-colored bedrock rubble in its wake. A single catastrophic flood capable of cutting into bedrock is extremely rare, but the Comal flood gave scientists a front-row ticket to an event similar to those from the planet's distant past, geologists said. Rapid megafloods may have formed other canyons in the distant past as glacial ice dams released trapped water. Large floods may be responsible for the formation of some Martian canyons as well, said geologists. At number 1. Meteor. Many meteors headed for Earth burn up in the planet's atmosphere. Those big enough to make it through leave quite an impression on the landscape. The Earth's wind, water and vegetation will eventually erase most craters. With few exceptions, even the largest craters are eventually destroyed by the processes of plate tectonics. The Barringer crater, also known as Meteor Crater, is a 0.8-mile diameter, 570-foot-deep hole in the flat, lying desert sandstones that lies 18.6 miles west of Winslow, Arizona. The world's best-preserved meteorite impact site on Earth. Located just minutes from Interstate 40 and the old Route 66 in northern Arizona near Winslow. Meteor Crater is the spectacular result of a collision that rocked the American Southwest approximately 50,000 years ago with the energy of more than 20 million tons of TNT. Situated under the wide skies of the Arizona high desert, Meteor Crater offers an interactive educational experience for the entire family in a beautiful, natural setting. The Meteor Crater Visitor Center is located on the rim of the crater. The fully air-conditioned building features an 80-seat widescreen theater, indoor crater viewing area, crater trail access, interactive discovery center, artifacts and exhibits, gift and mineral shop, collision, 4D experience room, and the blasted bistro. Elevators and ADA accessibility are available for guests with special needs.